Ladies and gentlemen, at this time I'm going to turn the microphone over to Mr. Al Capone. You guys are going to make a whole lot of noise while I'm doing that. You ready? Ready? Do it now. Thank you. About a year ago, Brian approached me. He actually cornered me in the driveway between the car and the steps leading to the house. I still remember that day. And he proceeded to ask me for Elizabeth's hand in marriage. And after the initial shock, I told Mary, and she thought it was cute. Call me skeptical, but I had a couple of questions. After all, this young man wants to marry my Elizabeth. Elizabeth, who, from the time she was born, through grade school, into college, and even now as a successful realtor, has always been very sweet and gentle. So I thought about it. Let's see. I've known Brian for about 7 years. He's always very polite with me. He's very, very smart. Graduated at the top of his class, went on to become a doctor in dental medicine. You know, a dentist. Elizabeth's sisters tell me that he's really good looking. I'm not a good judge in that department, but I guess. But let me check with somebody that I think really knows this. Hey, Yolanda. What do you think? You think Brian is good looking?
I think very good looking.
Additionally, Brian likes the same wines that I like. And like me, obviously, he has very good taste in women. So how bad can he be? So, my friends know that I don't usually speak in absolute terms, but I can say that of the 19 or so boyfriends that Elizabeth has brought home, Ryan is absolutely the best one. So, what am I going to say to this question? Maybe or not think about it? Of course I agreed right away. It was very happy to do so. So, for the last year, the women in the household have been in full wedding planning mode. I just love women, don't you? And I just did my part. I did what I was told. Show up on time, pick up your tuxedo, trim your mustache, stuff like that. But, along the way, I read somewhere that on the day of his daughter's wedding, the father of the bride usually has a little talk with the new son-in-law about love and commitment and sharing and understanding, you know, all that long walk on the beach kind of stuff, you know? But as I said before, Brian is very, very smart. He doesn't need to hear from me about that. And so I did make one suggestion to him a few weeks ago. I suggested that he build a pedestal for Elizabeth. Yeah, a pedestal so he can better worship her. That's all. So, I don't think I'll be talking to you, but instead, what I'm going to do is go sit with some friends, enjoy the party, and drink a couple of Grey Goose martinis. Very, very dry. So that when I have to. I won't be too embarrassed to do so.
I'm sorry. I'm afraid the girls aren't going to give you enough time for that.
Really?
I don't know what you've all been waiting for. The world famous Athletic Slams Twist Contest. Here this evening. Young lady, what is your name?
Mrs. Meemaw.
And how about your fellow here?
I can't believe I just did that. So, enough silly stuff. Time for a very short toast. Tonight, I'd like to give thanks to some of the people and some of the events that have altered my life in a very positive way. First, let me begin by thanking Anita and Dan, I can't see him, for giving birth to Brian. I also want to thank Walter, who is no longer with us, and Rita for giving birth to Mary. My wife, who gave birth to Elizabeth and four other beautiful girls. And I'm really grateful for that one moment in time and for that one place in this universe when and where Elizabeth met Brian. Salute, guys. Many years of good luck.
Put your hands together out there, Mr. Capone. Yes?